out, guns out, they say. But then those guns, huh? But today I want to talk to you about a sunny dog breed. It's named Basenji. It has a similar weight to my slippery when wet, to my black felt terrier that I have here. This is my black felt terrier. He is now Estacada, now 1 year old. A male dog. And this one weighs a little bit over 12 kilograms. That's also the size of an average Basenji. Also, both Basenji and Bratadil Terriers, that's the other name of the Black Fell Terrier, are hunting dogs. These ones are dogs that go underground, the Terriers ones are. So it needs to get the fox out or the badger out, and sometimes use as well above ground against a raccoon or other type of quarry, for example even hawk, whereas Basenji is more of a hunter on a quarry above ground. Of the smaller quarry, including rabbits, birds and the likes. It's a very special type of dog because it is still in its somewhat original form. The show breed has not that much detrimented it yet, which is a nice thing to see. You see also the muscles on my dog coming through. He's now shaping up nicely. Basenji is a dog originating from Africa, and they bring some very nice characteristics. For example, a Basenji does not bark. This little guy is a silent type of dog, also known as strong dog, who does not bark that much. But a Basenji does not bark. It cannot, because its throat is formed differently, but it can express its emotions in other ways. So a little bit like yodeling. And something else you even could imagine, because it is from Africa and it cannot bark, is you have your little pocket hyena. It looks a lot nicer. If we talk about the looks, it is a dog that also has a terrier type of looks about it. Although it's classified more as a Spitz type of dog, but then a short coated, of course. But if you look at it, it has a strong head and a keen expression. Also the body type, it could resemble that of a more solid type of fox terrier. I think if you would breed a fox terrier with a Staffordshire Bull Terrier, and then again back to the fox terrier, so that you have like 75% smooth-coated fox terrier and one quarter of Staffordshire Bull Terrier, to get it a stronger head, you would be quite close to the looks of Basenji. A Basenji, of course, being a Spitz type of dog, has that pricked up ears, so erect ears, instead of the ears going down with most terriers. But it is very nice. Also, you can imagine that if you would cross Bull Terrier, so the English Bull Terrier with something else, for example, there are not many other bigger type of terriers with erect ears. The Bull Terrier, they bred them in them, because it wasn't allowed to crop them anymore and they wanted to remain looking that way, to retain that look. But also, if you would cross Bull Terriers with Fox Terriers and would select on the erect ears, you could also come very close. The thing I like about the Basenji is that it's a small type of dog, but still sturdy. It's even more sturdy than a Fox Terrier, albeit saying that the character of a terrier is often, look at this beautiful flowers, very robust. And it's also a dog that the Basenji is, that has cat-like behavior, which also is a nice characteristic. You also see that this a little bit with the Chow Chow, the Chinese dog, and some other dog breeds. But especially Basenji has this a lot. So what this means is that it can be quite silent. But we already touched upon the topic, but also the most important part is that it grooms itself like a cat. So using its paws to groom its entire body, which is a nice feature. It also helps the Basenji for some people that like this for one reason or the other. One reason could be that they don't like the dog odor. I must say, for example, this type of dog also does very little dog odor. And it's not grooming itself like a cat. But Basenji has even less. And also the nice thing about a Basenji is that if you are looking for a hypoallergenic dog breed, you often need to go to dogs with a long coat. Whereas with the Basenji, you can get a sleek short coat and still be hypoallergenic. This is an enormous plus, because I think it's one of the only breeds that has that. Other breeds that come close are like pincher type of dogs. Goedemorgen. Prachtige morgen, lekker zonnetje.
Dus
wordt 30, hè?
Ja, de
ja, ik vind het wel lekker. Ja, maar ze is ook wat ouder, hè?
Je hebt nog een jas aan, hè?
Ja, hebben nog een jasje aan.
Wat niet?
Ze hebben nog een jasje aan, maar ziet er goed uit, toch?
Ja, ze wordt nog 9.
Ja, precies.
Hoe bezig komt, hè? Dat kan blijven gaan.
Dat is goed, het ziet er prachtig uit. Geen grijze snuit nog.
Maar hier toch niet gedaan, dus zijn het met één of twee, standen of kaal, ja.
De ander wordt het allebei. Nee, dat klopt. Maar als je actief blijft, geef je er wel de beste kans. En dat doe je.
Die dieren houden ons ook actief.
Dat is er zeker. Hoi hoi. Dat was Malinois. Het is quite a lot bigger type of dog. The colors of the Basenji are often white with brown markings. It can also be other colors, but those colors you find the most. You can also find them in, for example, brindle. So there are quite some differences that you can see there. If you're looking for a specific color, you could get lucky. Also, they don't throw normally just one type of color in a litter, but often it's quite mixed. So that's a nice thing to know. If you look at this body type of my Petterdale Terrier, it's more long in the back, as you can see, whereas the Basenji has a more square body type, a little bit less exaggerated as, for example, the current show Fox Terrier has. But it's a nice addition. And I also think that if you are looking for an interesting breed to combine, for example, with a whippet for a lurcher type of dog, I might think that the Basenji, especially if you could get like a Basenji strain that's still used for work, so hunting, could be a nice addition to your whippet. Also, it's good to notion that Basenjis are already very fast dogs. So they gallop a little bit like a racehorse, which is very pleasant to the eye, but also a fast way to take care of covering big slabs of distance in a short time. So it's an unusual dog breed that I like a lot. If you want one with a little bit more hair, there are alternatives, also hunting breeds like for example those that were used for catching, how do they call them? Yeah, we call them parrot divers, which is a bird species. Often found in the more northern regions of the world. For example, the Scandinavian countries. And they developed a dog breed, which name I now must... I have some troubles getting that name up for you, but I made a video about this type of dog. It's a dog that has great flexibility. It can turn its neck 180 degrees back, which is very interesting, and also can spread his legs to a complete split. It also carries more toes, one toe extra for additional grip, and can close its ears when it goes on the water. And that's a dog with a little bit more coat. More. Goedemorgen.
Goedemorgen.
Hoi hoi.
Hoi
ja. You could also look at the dogs that are not yet recognized by the kennel clubs, like the FCI, that are for example the tree climbing dogs that you find in Asia, which also have a lot of overlap with this Basenji type of dog, but are more work bred, and they use them, as the name implies, to climb trees. So this shows you something about their strength, which is not only the backhand, as you can see here. Often most of the power of a dog comes from the backhand, but also the front end. It's very powerful in this type of dogs. I hope you like this video. And I'm looking forward to the comments or the recommendations of another breed to review.